Good afternoon. This is All India Radio and I'm Sai Ramuj Taba with the Midday News. The headlines. Prime Minister Narendra Modi says innovation should be made part of education system to address problems of the society. Prime Minister to interact with BJP workers of 5 parliamentary constituencies through video conferencing this evening. President Ram Nath Kovind calls for achieving sustainable development goals, especially providing clean water and sanitation. External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj to address the United Nations General Assembly in New York this evening. And nearly 400 people killed in yesterday's earthquake and tsunami in Indonesia. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has said innovation should be made a part of education system to address the problems of the society. He was speaking at a function in New Delhi today after inaugurating a day-long conference on academic leadership on education for resurgence.
आज की शिक्षा के तीन स्तंभ है जीवन निर्माण मानवता और चरित्र गठन स्वामी जी के इन्हीं विचारों से प्रेरित होकर के मैं आज इसमें एक और स्तंभ जोड़ने का साहस कर रहा हूं और वो है नवोन्मेष इनोवेशन जब इनोवेशन अटक जाता है तो जिंदगी ठहर जाती है अगर हम इन चारों पहलुओं को लेकर अपनी उच्च शिक्षा के पुनरुत्थान के बारे में सोचेंगे तो हमें एक सही दिशा दिखाई देती
है। The Prime Minister underlined the need for making educational institutions stakeholders in society to address its problems. He said the country has billions of solutions to address millions of problems.
मेरा आग्रह कि विद्यार्थियों को कॉलेज यूनिवर्सिटी के क्लासरूम में तो ज्ञान दें ही लेकिन उन्हें देश की आशा आकांक्षाओं के साथ भी जोड़ना होगा इसी मार्ग पर चलते हुए केंद्र सरकार की भी यही कोशिश है कि हम हर स्तर पर देश की आवश्यकताओं में शिक्षण संस्थानों को भागीदार बनाएं इसी विजन के साथ हमने अटल टिंकरिंग लैब की शुरुआत की है इसमें स्कूली बच्चों में इनोवेशंस की प्रवृत्ति बढ़ाने पर फोकस किया जा रहा है
Mr. Modi said education is the key factor for all-round development of humanity and quoted Swami Vivekananda and Rabindranath Tagore in this regard. The Prime Minister suggested engagement of students to spread the benefits of governmental welfare policies and schemes in respect of health, education, malnutrition and cleanliness.
हमारे विद्यार्थियों को जिम्मेदारी दी जा सकती है कि वह अपने आसपास के लोगों को डिजिटल लिटरेट बनाने का काम करें वे अपने आसपास के लोगों का आयुष्मान भारत उजाला स्वच्छ भारत मिशन जैसी योजनाओं से परिचित कराएं वो उनके जीवन को आसान बना सकती है विद्यार्थी अपने लोकैलिटी में जल संरक्षण पर्यावरण और बिजली बचाने की सीख दे ऐसे अनेक कार्यों की लिस्ट शिक्षा संस्थान एक दूसरे से साझा भी कर सकते हैं
He said the government has started a program called Revitalization of Infrastructure and Systems in Education, or RISE, to strengthen educational infrastructure. In this context, he said the government will spend 1 lakh crore rupees on higher education by 2022. Vice chancellors and directors from more than 350 universities are attending the conference. Human Resource Development Minister Prakash Javadekar underlined the need for encouraging the use of technologies in the education system. He said there has been a 70% increase in the budget for education from 63,000 crore to 1,10,000 crore rupees and 55% hike in the disbursement of scholarships. The Prime Minister will interact with BJP workers of Bilaspur, Basti, Dhanbad, Chittorgarh and Mandsaur parliamentary constituencies under the Mera Booth Sabse Mazboot Samvad program through video conferencing today. The interaction will be available on the Narendra Modi application from 4:30 p.m. Earlier, Mr. Modi had interacted with BJP workers of Arunachal West, Ghaziabad, Hazaribagh, Jaipur Rural and Nawada parliamentary constituencies. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will share his thoughts with the people in India and abroad in his Mann Ki Baat program on All India Radio tomorrow morning. It will be the 48th episode of the monthly program. The program will be broadcast on the entire network of All India Radio and Doordarshan at 11 a.m. President Ram Nath Kovind has called for achieving the sustainable development goals, particularly providing clean water and sanitation. inaugurating a four-day convention on Mahatma Gandhi International Sanitation in New Delhi, Mr. Kovind said absence of suitable toilets, appropriate hygiene and sanitation practices can lead to lifelong disadvantages. He said Swachh Bharat is critical to securing human capital and demographic dividend in providing better future for children. The president said achieving universal access to adequate and equitable sanitation and hygiene by 2030 is a major challenge in many parts of the world.
Achieving universal access to adequate and equitable sanitation and hygiene by 2030 is a major challenge in many parts of the world. Drinking water, sanitation and hygiene are central to Sustainable Development Goal 6. They are also essential to the health and well-being of our people.
Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu has said the governments have been constantly trying to improve the school infrastructure, but much more needs to be done. He said the results of surveys of learning outcomes in village schools show that quality of learning is a matter of great concern in many schools, especially in rural areas. Mr. Naidu was addressing students during the launch of 100 digital classrooms in 75 rural government schools around Gwalior in Madhya Pradesh today. My School Digital School is sponsored by Union Minister for Rural Development, Narendra Singh Tomar, and Hindustan Zinc, and implemented by Muskan Foundation. Giving advice to the teachers, Vice President said they must promote active learning and enable children to learn by discoursing, questioning, and experimenting. Mr. Naidu said India's future is bright because the younger generation have the ability to develop innovative ideas.
India's future is bright because it rests on the innovative abilities of a younger generation. They have the drive to make a difference. They have the character, they have the caliber, they have the capacity. And if they conduct themselves, we can do wonders. They have ideas and vision for their country. We only have to provide facilities to make realize their dreams. The story is really remarkable.
This is All India Radio giving you the news. For quick news updates round the clock, follow us on Twitter at AIR News Alerts. External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj will address the 73rd session of the UN General Assembly in New York this evening. The general debate opened on Tuesday and will run till Monday. Ms. Swaraj, who addressed the general debate last year as well, reached New York last Saturday and participated in several bilateral, plurilateral and multilateral meetings. Speaking at a SOC meeting on the sidelines of the UNGA session, Ms. Swaraj called for efforts to eliminate terrorism in all its forms. In the presence of her Pakistani counterpart, Shah Mahmood Qureshi, Ms. Swaraj said an environment of peace and security in South Asia is essential for cooperation and economic development. The SAR grouping includes India, Pakistan and six other regional countries. Ms. Swaraj also attended the meeting of foreign ministers of BRICS, that is Brazil, Russia, India, China and South Africa. She said the member states should speak with a stronger voice on the critical issue of achieving the long-pending UN Security Council reform. Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Grameen aims to provide a pakka house with basic amenities by 2022 to those who do not own a house and also to those who live in a dilapidated house. The immediate objective is to cover 1 crore households in 3 years from 2016-17 to 2018-19. Here is a ground report from our Mumbai correspondent.
With Union Government making efforts to provide housing to all, transformation is visible in the lives of people who could not have a shelter of their own. In Maharashtra, out of the 50,000, 1,646 houses have been constructed till now. To ensure that the selection is objective and verifiable, the beneficiary is selected using housing deprivation parameters in the socio-economic and caste census 2011, verified by the Gram Sabhas. We spoke to Mr. Ashish Rawat from Palghar district, who is one such beneficiary.
मैंने भोजसर में एक फ्लैट लिया, उसमें प्रधानमंत्री आवास योजना के लिए भी फॉर्म भरा और वो फॉर्म के वजह से मुझे कुछ ज्यादा पेपर वर्क करना नहीं पड़ा. बैंक वालों ने मुझे बहुत हेल्प किया और मुझे खाली पैन कार्ड, आधार कार्ड और कुछ छोटे मोटे डॉक्यूमेंट्स देने पड़े. तो मैंने हर अपने दोस्त को वो योजना के बारे में बताया.
प्रोग्राम इम्प्लीमेंटेशन एंड मॉनिटरिंग इज कैरिड आउट थ्रू एन एंड टू एंड ई गवर्नेंस मॉडल यूजिंग आवास सॉफ्ट एंड आवास ऐप. ऑल पेमेंट्स टू बेनिफिशियरीज आर डन थ्रू डायरेक्ट बेनिफिट ट्रांसफर. This scheme is actually playing a major role in ushering the change in building a new India. Madhuri Pange, AIR News, Mumbai.
Assam government will launch wage compensation scheme for pregnant women in tea gardens of the state. Health Minister Hemant Biswa Sarma said that the scheme will provide better health and nutrition supplements to pregnant women. More from our correspondent.
An amount of 12,000 rupees is to be given to the pregnant woman so that she could take care of herself and unborn baby without compromising the livelihood of her family. The scheme will be launched on 1st of October in the state. The compensation of wages to pregnant women would be given in 4 installments. The scheme is also likely to reduce maternal and neonatal mortality in the trigger years. Manas Padim Sharma, AR News, Guwahati.
In the Parakram Parv celebrations going on in the country, Shaurya Smarak of Madhya Pradesh is the place to witness the challenges of soldiers, their work profile and the kind of sacrifices they make. Our correspondent reports that the first of its kind in India, the Shaurya Smarak, is a unique war memorial in Bhopal. The Smarak was inaugurated by Prime Minister Narendra Modi on 14th of October 2016. A report.
The Shaurya Smarak, built at a cost of around 41 crore rupees and spread over and more than 12 acres, is a tribute to the Indian Armed Forces. The Shaurya Smarak mainly of a 62 feet tall pillar, the Shaurya Stam, around which names of the fallen soldiers have been inscribed on glass board, a museum, an open air amphitheater and information center. Beside the Shaurya Stam, there is a Smarak Jyoti, which is lit in holographic flame for the honor of the martyrs. The main attraction of the museum is a gallery which allows visitors to experience the cold of Siachen Glacier and understand the terrains of the Siachen war zone. Sanjeev Sharma, AIR News, Bhopal.
In Assam, Parakram Parv has been organized at Air Force Station, Guwahati and Narangi Military Station. Various types of weapons and equipment of the army are on display at the Narangi Military Station. A selfie corner has also been established to enable the visitors to take the selfie. The Air Force showcases their various equipments to include Mi-17 helicopter, AVRO, drone air, various radars employed in the Air Force and emergency medical support system. The event was inaugurated by Air Commodore S. Mishra, Air Force Station, Guwahati. Information and Broadcasting Ministry has also displayed various motivational and informative boards to enlighten the students. In Indonesia, nearly 400 people have been killed in a devastating earthquake and tsunami in Palu City on Sulawesi Island yesterday. The National Disaster Agency of the country said hospitals are struggling to cope with hundreds of injured and rescuers scrambling to reach the stricken region. In the city of Palu, partially covered bodies lay on the ground near the shore. There are also concerns over the whereabouts of hundreds of people preparing for a beach festival due to start yesterday evening. The tsunami was triggered by a strong quake that brought down buildings and sent locals fleeing for higher ground. Reports say that the shallow 7.5 magnitude tremor was more powerful than a series of quakes that killed hundreds on the Indonesian island of Lombok in July and August. Indonesian President Joko Widodo said military has been called into the disaster-struck region to help search and rescue teams get to victims and find their bodies. Typhoon Trami hit Japan's southern island of Okinawa with a maximum speed of 216 kilometers per hour today. Officials said at least 5 people have been injured so far, but no one is feared dead. Public broadcaster NHK reports that some 600 people have been evacuated to shelters and at least 386 flights have been cancelled, mainly in western Japan. Maldives Elections Commission EC has confirmed that Ibrahim Mohamed Saleh has won the presidential election held last Sunday. EC announced the final result of the election at a press conference today. It stated that President Abdullah Yameen, the candidate of the ruling party, received 96,052 votes, while Mr. Saleh, the candidate of the opposition coalition, received 1,34,705. The opposition had grown increasingly concerned over the EC's delay in announcing the final result amid speculation that ruling party may file complaints. Former President Mohamed Nasheed, while welcoming the result, said the people of the Maldives have endorsed democracy again. And now before we close the headlines once again. Prime Minister Narendra Modi says innovation should be made part of education system to address problems of the society. Prime Minister to interact with BJP workers of 5 parliamentary constituencies through video conferencing this evening. President Ramnath Kovind calls for achieving sustainable development goals, especially providing clean water and sanitation. External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj to address the United Nations General Assembly in New York this evening, and nearly 400 people killed in yesterday's earthquake and tsunami in Indonesia. For details of these stories and more, log on to our website www.newsonair.nic.in. With that, we end the midday news.